Good morning, my friend. I hope you're doing well. It's going to be a beautiful day out here on the river. It's about 28 degrees and it's super dark outside here still. But I'm just thinking this morning, I got an email yesterday from actually on the prayer wall from somebody who has a 42-year-old brother who is recently diagnosed with glioblastoma, has a young family, and that's just a devastating thing. It's one of these massive things that comes along in life when you get a terminal diagnosis or some really bad news or something happens that's going to change the arc of the story of your life forever. And what do you do then? And if you get out on the prayer wall at wlmd.com/prayer, or if you just pay attention to life, you're going to see a lot of things around you that are hard. You may be going through one of those things right now. Lisa and I call it the massive thing. Or you might be going through a series of many massive things. These like death by a thousand cuts. Your life might just feel consistently hard. Like, when's it going to stop being hard? And thinking about that email yesterday, I remember a Quiet Time episode did a while back. There was a day that our dog Lewis was getting unintentionally shocked by his collar. And his response to that was to run to his people. He didn't know how to tell us what was hurting. He didn't know why he was hurting. He just needed to be around us. And it took a while for us to figure out what was happening. But this is a Quiet Time we did a while back about, if you're just in one of those times when everything hurts and it just feels like life is really hard, there's a reliable thing that you can do that'll make it better. I can't promise you that the hard things will stop, but I can promise you that there's a path to finding hope and healing and maybe happiness or peace or some way to understand what you're going through and grappling with it in a little bit healthier way. There's a path for what to do when life feels really hard and when it feels like you're getting shocked. And this Quiet Time will do that. It's kind of a wild card Wednesday. Sometimes on Wednesdays, I just bring you something from the past or something random that I'm thinking about. And so today, I want to give you this Quiet Time episode back, because I think it'll be really helpful. If you're in one of those times when everything just hurts and it just feels hard, here's a strategy for what you can do when you keep getting shocked by life and you don't know why. Lisa's going to tell us the good news, my friend, is that we can start today.
Hey, are you ready to change your life? If the answer is yes, there's only one rule. You have to change your mind first. And my friend, there's a place where the neuroscience of how your mind works smashes together with faith, and everything starts to make sense. That place is called self-brain surgery. You can learn it, and it will help you become healthier, feel better, and be happier. And the good news is, you can start today.
Thanks, Lisa. Hey, so glad to have you listening today. I'm Dr. Lee Warren, and I live in Nebraska in the United States of America with my incredible wife, Lisa, my father-in-law, Tata, and the super pups, Harvey and Lewis. I'm a neurosurgeon and an author, and I'm here to help you harness neuroscience, the power of your brain, faith, the power of your spirit, and good old common sense to help you lead a healthier, better, happier life. Listen, friend, you can't change your life until you change your mind, and I'm here to help you learn the art of self-brain surgery to get it done. If you like the show, please subscribe so you never miss an episode, and tell your friends about it. If you tell two or three friends this podcast was helpful to you, imagine how much good we can all do around the world together. I'm Dr. Lee Warren, and I'm here to help you change your mind so you can change your life. Let's get after it.
Just want to share a quick little Quiet Time this morning. Yesterday, we were working in the shop a little bit, and Lewis, our two dogs have very different personalities. Harvey likes to run around all the time. Lewis likes to kind of hang a little closer to the people. Harvey comes and checks in and goes back out and, you know, finds a mole or something. Lewis will stay a little closer most of the time. And he was in the shop with us. Harvey was outside. And all of a sudden, Lisa noticed that Lewis was on the ground, and he just was kind of shivering, and he wasn't moving or crying or anything. It was just kind of shaking. And then all of a sudden he ran over to Lisa and jumped up in her lap and just was like basically like a little kid, like holding on to her, just scared. And we realized that his GPS collar was shocking him in the shop. It was shocking him over and over because it must have disconnected from the satellite or something, and the software must have defaulted to thinking that he had left the digital fence he was supposed to be in. So it was shocking him, and he didn't know what was wrong. You know, he didn't know why he was hurting. He didn't know why he was getting punished. He didn't know what he was doing wrong. He just knew that life had brought him some pain, and his solution to it was to run to his people, to jump into the arms of his mom who would help him. He didn't know what was wrong, but he knew where to go for help. And Lisa took his collar off and he calmed down and he was okay. And he was seeking the help of the person that he trusted to give him relief from his troubles. And this is a I'm not trying to strain the metaphor too far, but I just want to tell you, when life is bringing you trouble and you don't understand it and you can't see why it's so hard and the things are hurting and you don't even have words for some of the things you're experiencing, the answer is to run to the Father. I promise you, you spend a little time in Psalm 34 today. I don't know if you go to church or not. I don't know if you're a person of faith or not. But if you're not, especially if you're not, trust me. I know that you've never heard me lie to you. I know that if you've listened to my podcast very long, if you're getting my newsletter, if you're not, by the way, go to wleewarnmd.com/newsletter and just check out the newsletter. Every week, a new prescription for how you can change your mind and change your life and find hope in this sometimes difficult life. But if you're not getting the newsletter, check it out. But if you've been around me for a little bit, and by the way, welcome all those new people coming from MyBridge Radio. I see a bunch of you signing up. There's some Australian radio stations that are running some of my content now and getting several new people. Jen Jones, welcome aboard from Adelaide. She checked in via email yesterday, and we're glad to have all of you. But if you're new around here, you'll trust me over time. If you've been around a while, though, I know that you know I've never led you astray. I know that when I've given you a prescription, if you've really tried it out, it's worked, because my prescriptions all come from neuroscience and from Scripture. And when those two things come together, it teaches you how to change your brain so that your life can get better. And if you spend a little time in Psalm 34, you'll see that the answer when life is hard is to run to the Father. David says this: I sought the Lord, starting in verse 4. I sought the Lord, and he answered me. He delivered me from all my fears. Those who look to him are radiant. Their faces are never covered with shame. This poor man called, and the Lord heard him and saved him out of all his troubles. Listen, friend, some of you are going through some stuff right now. We have a friend from a former different part of our life who's going through an impossible situation. In just unacceptably difficult situation. And I don't know what the answer is. God does. And this friend is suffering, and I've been asking you to pray for him. I can't tell you more, but a relative of his figured out I was talking about him and emailed me separately and said, hey, thanks for the prayers. Like, listen, when you're hurting and when you don't know what to do, circle back to the Father. This poor man called, and the Lord heard him and saved him out of all his troubles. When the collar is shocking you and you don't know why and you don't know what to do, God will help you. I promise he will. Get around his people. Get around his word. Get around some worship music. Get around just somebody who can help you see him a little bit more clearly. Meditate on his word. And as verse 8 in Psalm 34 says, taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the one who takes refuge in him. We're going to talk in the coming days as we get more into Action April. We're going to talk about the fear of the Lord. And that's a funny thing, the fear of the Lord. Look at verse 9. Fear the Lord, you his holy people, for those who fear him lack nothing. And it sounds crazy to say that we should fear the Lord, because we don't like to be afraid. But that's not what the fear of the Lord's all about. We're going to talk about that in coming days. But I'm just going to tell you that Oswald Chambers said it best. He said, if you fear God, you fear nothing else. If you don't fear God, you fear everything else. I just read a book called Rejoice and Tremble by Michael Reeves that has messed my brain up about the fear of the Lord. And I'm going to share a lot with you. And I think I'm going to be able to get him on the podcast soon to talk about it. But I'm telling you that the answer to what scares you in life is to run to the Father. He's terrifying. He's awesome. He's holy, and he is mighty, and he is powerful. And sometimes it's scary to think about such an awesome God who can create and destroy and bring life and do everything like that. But at the same time, he's the one that's powerful enough to handle anything that you're dealing with, friend. So just seek him and you will find him. Verse 10, the lions may grow weak and hungry, but those who seek the Lord lack no good thing. I'm just going to give you Psalm 34 to think about today. Go to worship. Spend some time with your people. Put whatever you're scared of in the lap and the arms of the Father. And remember, Psalm 34:18, the Lord is close to the brokenhearted and saves those who are crushed in spirit. I'm telling you, this scripture, Psalm 34, got me through. It was my power. It was my go-to touch point when I lost my son, Mitch. I kept going back to Psalm 34 because I needed those promises to be true. And guess what? It turns out that they are. The Lord is close to you when you're brokenhearted. You can taste and see that he's good. When you're getting shocked and you don't understand what's happening and you can't figure out where the pain is coming from, run to the Father. Crawl up in his lap like Lisa did, like Lewis did with Lisa yesterday. He'll take that collar off. He may not be able to make it stop hurting immediately. He may not be able to understand it all immediately, but you'll be in the right place and it'll immediately start feeling better because you'll have some clarity that you're in the arms of the only one who can actually fix the situation that you're dealing with or can help you process it or go through it. I promise you, that's the solution when you're hurting, to run to the Father. Here's Cody Carnes. This is my favorite version of this song, Run to the Father. A couple years ago, this song was everywhere and a bunch of different people recorded it, but Cody Carnes wrote it. He recorded it at the Motion Conference, which was at our old church in Alabama, at the Birmingham campus of Highland, the Church of the Highlands. And this Motion Conference was their teenage conference, and it was just a powerful event. And he's saying, this is my favorite version of this song, Run to the Father. Just spend a minute here. It's a long, drawn-out version of that song. It's almost 9 minutes long. But just worship a little bit. Go get Psalms 34 on whatever device or Bible or wherever you read the scripture, and just spend a few minutes here in this quiet time. I promise you it will help. When life is shocking you, friend, you can run to the Father and he will help you and it'll get better. But you have to start today.
running to where my head comes from. The arms of the Father, the arms of my Father, always open wide, always open wide. You've always been by my side. You've never left. You've seen every tear I've cried, every moment. My heart is spinning your sights long before my first breath. Running into your arms is running to life from death. Oh, I feel this rush deep in my chest. Your mercy is cold. Just as I am, you pull me in, and I know I need you now. My heart has been in your sights long before my first breath. Running into your arms is running to life from.
Hey, thanks for listening. Please subscribe to the show so you automatically get every episode. And if you like the show, you'll love my weekly letter. Check out my writing at drleewarren.substack.com, drleewarren.substack.com. Get the free newsletter every week for my best prescriptions for becoming healthier, feeling better, and being happier through the power of faith and neuroscience smashing together via self-brain surgery. drleewarren.substack.com. And if you need prayer, go to the prayer wall at wleewarrenmd.com/prayer. The theme music for the show is Make Us One by Tommy Walker, graciously provided for free by the great folks over at tommywalkerministries.org. Check it out and consider supporting them. tommywalkerministries.org. Remember, you can't change your life until you change your mind. And the good news is you can start today. I'm Dr. Lee Warren. I'll talk to you soon. God bless you, friend. Have a great day.